work from home, Deepa, you've been doing a lot of work on that. Ab aap Deepa hain, is pe kuch prakash daliye.
Well, it looks different now than it did before.
What was different before? Yeah.
Well, earlier it was rare, it was restricted, it was limited to certain classes of jobs, you know, telesales workers, etc. And it lacked respect. There was a certain stigma associated with it. Shirk from home was kind of the default association with.
Ghar baith ke kaam karega ki nahi koi. So COVID changed everything.
That's pervasive social distancing policies made it the norm, and I think people's work habits have adapted, started to change.
Because we were forced to adapt to it.
Correct, you were forced to adapt to it, and therefore you were working in challenging conditions at home with kids.
So with selection, you only did it if it was working, but now when you're forced to it, those conditions may not be there.
Correct.
So as you mentioned, for example, kids.
Absent infrastructure, you may not have a home office environment set up.
So is it working for the organization?
So I think there are clear benefits, right, in terms of you save on costly rentals in dense urban centers, you save on that.
Less office space.
Less office space. There's less commute time for your employees. They're working therefore longer perhaps. There's that. But you're also making investments, right, in connectivity, remote infrastructure, communication infrastructure. And also work from home does not work without effective performance management and review systems. You need these performance management and review. So those costs that go away are offset by these costs that you need to bring in.
Is it working on average? Working. So I know Bloom has done some work.
The study by Bloom is actually pre-pandemic, where he does find an improvement in productivity of work from home employees, but keep in mind that the home office environment
selection
there
was there. Yeah, so it was chosen to be where it was likely to work the most.
Correct. And the sample came to office once or twice a week.
This is different now. So what does the evidence say now?
So now there's mixed evidence at best, and there's little causal studies of productivity improvements. However, I would say, notwithstanding productivity, there are a couple of things that are clear that don't work.
Oh. Okay, what doesn't work?
So, creative innovation, big ideas, and the creativity that fuels these big ideas or innovation in companies comes from social interactions, comes from collaborations, comes from teams. The idea of the lone inventor churning out ideas is dead. It's been rejected.
The very idea of a firm is that people come together and work together, and
correct,
you learn from each other, which is largely absent when you're working from home.
Correct, correct.
So for the organizations themselves, if it's a routine work that's repetitive, that's okay, but anything that requires beyond that is probably not likely to work.
One may argue that the infrastructure that you're putting in place, the communication and collaboration infrastructure, allows you to recreate and simulate collaboration teamwork like you could on site. But that also has been rejected.
So the evidence is not supportive.
No, there's a study, a recent study, which looks at video calls and their effectiveness. And in large collaborative environments, things like, you know, visual cues, gestures, all of those are missed.
I hate those. I hate those video calls which has more than five people.
Yeah.
Because, you know,
you can't see everybody.
You can't see everybody, and then somebody's audio goes off and you hear something in the background. It's a complete mess.
Yeah.
For the organization's point of view, can I summarize by saying that the evidence is not super clear, but it might work in some cases.
You may say that. Can I also add one important element to that, which is the organizational identity? When people are working in their respective quartets or corners and they're working from home, then that identity is lost, and therefore employee
you're
loyalty is muted.
Not as loyal, you're moonlighting, you're working on more than one job, you don't
identify. And you've
identify.
Heard evidence of that, right?
Yes, indeed. But let's now switch and say from the point of view of employees.
Hmm.
More flexibility?
Hmm.
Do meetings from sitting on the potty? Right? Work anytime? That looks like good news, isn't it?
Yeah, for those reasons and more. It's also, it saves you commute time. There's the whole notion of you're able to have a better work-life balance.
So more choice.
More choice.
How can it be bad?
Maybe not. If your job requires complementarities with other people,
then
requires collaboration, then don't do it. The second is actually the more interesting but persistent finding in the work from home research. There is a promotion penalty associated with your family.
You're less likely to be promoted if you're working from home. Is it because you're not visible?
Yes. Also keep in mind that what we talked about, high growth, innovation, all of that's happening on premise. It's happening in the office. And if you're not there, you're not rationing up the growth trajectory of the firm, then, you know, you're likely to be held back. But yes, there is. So there's this study, again, the same study by Bloom, which finds that you're 50% less likely to be promoted over a 2-year period.
50%. That's a huge penalty.
That's a huge.
So I think if I'm an employee, I should say no if I was given the choice.
Yeah, you should say no. I would say if you want to be a part of the growth trajectory, you want to be seen in the firm, then come to work.
Come to work. Okay, let's talk about women.
We must talk about women.
Okay, we must talk about. This looks like good news for women because, you know, women have many other things to do. Flexibility gives them that chance to now work from home.
So women actually have a double whammy, Bhagwan. So,
why, you know, why double? What are the two things?
One, to your point, I'm curious about why you think that. So they are indeed 50% more likely to choose work from home when given the choice.
Socialization tells me that I should do. Plus, ghar se ja rahe to maa bolegi, saasu bolegi, kyon ja rahe ho? Ghar se bhi to kar sakti ho.
Social pressures.
The social that pressure. Lead,
and there's also a socialized instinct. Let's also, you know, give them some burden of the choice, right? They make this choice. It's a preference, whatever it is. But there is a socialized instinct and there are social pressures.
Yeah. So that's not good for my growth.
No, it's
even
not.
Though the company may say it's okay.
It's not.
It's not so good for me.
No, it's not. Because you are choosing to work from home while your male colleagues are out there,
meeting the bosses, doing the creative things, and getting the next promotion.
And, yes,
and you will be left
behind.
And
you are held back because you're not visible and you're not there. The second is that there is this very interesting finance paper that we've talked about before, which is where women hedge fund managers, the returns on their portfolio were about 9% less abnormal returns on the male hedge fund managers' portfolio during the month of school closures in the early days of the pandemic.
Yeah, so they weren't able to pay as much attention.
Correct. Which means
so
that
their productivity is lower.
Correct.
As well.
So they're kind
That's
of,
what you mean by the double whammy.
You bear the burden of unpaid care work. And that translates to more costs for you for paid work, right? So it's a double whammy.
So I would say if you're an employee, if you're a woman employee and you're given that choice, don't fall for it. It's tempting, but don't take it. Right?
I would agree.
Okay.
I would agree.
Plus, if you're an organization and you claim that you are for welfare, you want the women to become leaders, do not give them that choice. That seems counterintuitive. But that's what we are saying. If you give them the choice, they will fall into the trap. What we are concluding is that work for home may look attractive in the short term.
Yeah.
In the long term, it may not be such a great idea.
Yeah, I agree with you. And I, let me also extend that organization part, which is I think that you also end up creating less diversity in your organization.
Yes,
right?
Indeed.
So for that reason, indeed, organizations must either have a policy that cuts across and ask everybody to come in or everybody.
Or if you have to ask, maybe ask only the women to come. Let the men stay at home and take care of kids. How about that?
Sure.
Okay.
Sounds good.
On that note, we are going to stop.
Thank you very much.